Hello everybody, welcome to our next webinar with the topic Various Software Tools for KNX. My name is Thorsten Reibel, I'm here together with Jürgen Schilder, and we will share this webinar today, which takes around 1 hour, maybe a bit more, but around 1 hour. Yeah, and as always, we will send you later in the next days the recording of this webinar together with the video, but also the presentation slides. Good, let's start. So what is planned for today? The topic is various software tools for KNX. So it's a collection of information we have. I will start with the topic firmware update of KNX devices. There is a, yeah, at the beginning kind of general information we would like to give to you. But later during our different topics, we also talk about how to start a firmware update for different KNX devices. I will continue then with the ETS apps. There are different apps available. More or less standard apps from ABB, but we have also these so-called DCA concept, device configuration apps. I would like to explain a bit because they are also the first products behind from ABB. Then Jürgen will continue with very short only the ABB IBAS tool because already done in former webinars, but there are also some actual information and a topic which is not maybe so common, analyzing of KNX Net IP telegrams on IP level. You know, we have more and more KNX devices with KNX Net IP connection or IP connection in general and KNX Net IP telegrams, and also here is an option now to analyze if necessary the telegrams. So I start with the firmware update of KNX devices. So firmware, what does it mean? We have of course KNX devices which have hard and software, and the software for us is mainly the application, the ETS application, where we parameterize the functions and download later this application into the component. But in the background there is also a firmware, which is also an essential part of a product. Yeah, and normally we did not take care of this so much in the past, but now it's getting more and more important to take care of and to take action if necessary. Because the components are getting more and more comprehensive and powerful, more and more functions are inside, and this results in a also powerful firmware behind. So what does it mean finally for us? A new firmware version might appear, might exist, and which contains maybe necessary adaptations, but also new features can be integrated. So finally, it's sometimes necessary to update a product with a new firmware. So, and a KNX project is not always online, like your PC, like your smartphone, where any updates can be easily noted and executed. So firmware updates for KNX devices have to be initiated by the user, system integrator or installer, so have to be done intentionally. And this is now more and more a topic we have to take care of, and you will see first of all how can we do firmware updates in our KNX world. There are at the moment three different solutions. One is the updating via ABB IBAS tool. We will show everything around this, how it works. There are three components behind: IP router, IP interface and the logic controller. Then we have this ETS app, KNX Bus Update. So this is a real app integrated in the ETS, where we have now also more and more components to be updated this way. So at the moment the DALI gateway, push presence detector, motion detector, the new universal dim actuator, LED dim actuator, many of our climate echo devices, and in future maybe more. And a bit specific but also necessary in some components, we have a web user interface, and in this such a case we do the firmware update here in this web user interface, and this is related now to the at the moment to the security panel, to the energy analyzer, and to the application controller in our climate echo range. So it's the way we are web user interface. And situation at the moment is that we have an important update available for in total 4 products. So the IP router, IPRS311, IP interface, IPSS311, security panel GMA, and also our logic controller ABAS121. There is an important and a firmware update necessary, which has to be done finally. And status at the moment, February 2019, this update has to be done, and you will see later the version which is behind. just to have an optimal operational performance in these devices and of course and also a long-term stability of this component in the application. So it's really a must to update this. Again, we show for all these products how to do this, and so try to do it as early as possible for these four devices. The DALI Gateway DGS, one or twofold, 6411, there's also firmware and also updated and also new ETS application available. There are two or three bugs removed, so also here really recommended to update this component. So keep this in mind, later we come back to this topic and we come to the different components. So this first of all for the firmware update. Now I would like to go to the ETS apps. And this is a topic not completely new, just a general information. What does it mean? Of course, we have our ETS Professional, for complete programming and designing of projects. And you download everything via the ETS into the component. But there are apps available for the ETS. In principle, two versions of apps. One app, or apps which are adding functionality to the ETS in general. And now coming more and more apps having functionality for a product. So in addition to the parameter button, you will see later a DCA button just to configure components. And we have the first two components in our ABB range which are supporting this additional feature. But I come to this a bit later, what's really behind. So all ETS apps must be downloaded and installed. This is on the homepage available, or on the KNX homepage, or our own homepage as well, partly, but I will explain. So non-DCA apps, so these general apps, let's say, not only product-related, must be additionally purchased and licensed from the KNX homepage on your account. I will show you how it works. And and our DCA apps, you later will see it, need no license. Yeah. So these apps are available on the MyKNX account. The device configuration apps, because they are really product-related, are also on our homepage, so on the homepage of the manufacturer, and you find it in the location of our homepage where you have also all the information around the products. Yeah. So these apps, company-related apps, let's say, are typically free of charge. There are, of course, more apps on the market, also from the KNX organization, for different purposes. You have to pay sometimes. Anything for this depends. And but more or less all product-related or company-related apps are free of charge. But you still see it in the shop of the KNX organization, what is behind. Yeah. All these apps are able to be used in the ETS 5 and the actual ETS version also, partly also in ETS 4, depends a bit. The DCA, the device configuration app, this concept is only supported by ETS 5. So if you have a product, and we have two at the moment, where you need the DCA concept, then you need ETS 5. So how to get an app and also the related license file, if necessary. You go on my.knx.org, then you sign in into your account, you have to have, otherwise you have no access to all these apps, but it's easy to register there. Then you go to the ETS apps, and or to shop first of all, where you find ETS apps. You see it here, shop, and then ETS apps will be shown. You have a look to all the existing apps, and ABB apps as well. And then you select this app you would like to have, and you can order this. Yeah. So then this app you have ordered appears in your account under products, and you can download this app. Yeah. But in addition, you need a license, and this license is available as well there. You have to enter your license ID of your ETS. Yeah. You can find it if you go on your ETS on the lower right side. You have this licensing for the ETS 5, there's also the number of your license visible, KNX dash, and then there's a number behind. And if you insert this license number here, you can download also the related license file for this app, because you need it to be licensed in the ETS itself. So it's a bit, yeah, bureaucratic process, but if you know how it works, and we have described it here also on the right, you will find now a lot of screenshots of all the steps I will explain here, and it should be possible to do it also later then by your own. So you download the product license file additionally, and then you have to install it, of course, in the ETS. You start your ETS, and on the lower right side you find also a button apps. Yeah, and if you click there, something like this opens here, where you can add via the plus, or you can import via this plus symbol the app file you have downloaded already. Yeah. So the app will be then installed on your PC, and it appears then here as an additional app in the list behind. Yeah. Then there's another button for licensing, and because you have to insert also your license from the app, where you click also on plus, and then you locate the license file you have downloaded from the KNX account, from your KNX account, and finally your app is licensed. So it's again here also a bit process, but I think you have, if you have done it once, it's not so complicated. Important is that, different from the ETS itself, where you get an information if there is an update available, these apps are not automatically updated, or you get no automatic information there is an update for an app available. So if you click here on these, under license, on this green round arrow, you can check for updates, and you will find some information if an update for an ETS app is available. So, and what kind of ABB apps we have at the moment? There are some available, so I will explain a bit what is behind. So, split unit gateway SUG/U, there we need also an app. Though it's a more product-related app, it's not a DCA, not a device configuration app, but yeah, it was done a bit earlier, so here we'll see how it works. So that's the first app, then the KNX Bus Update app. Practically, it's firmware update via ETS. Update Copy Convert is one app with, I think, 4 or 5 different functions behind. So very comprehensive app we have here. And then our colleagues from AB France, from Neuron, have created recently a so-called Move and Group app, also for the ETS. It's a very powerful solution for creating projects the easy way. I explain also here a bit. And then an app for our comfort panel, big touch panel we have in KNX, where we have an own software behind to parameterize IP project. And as you need also the, let me say, connection to the ETS with group addresses, you have here also a kind of app take the data from the ETS to the IP project and vice versa, but I will explain. And then I mentioned already 2 device configuration apps, DCA, for the 2 components we have already now in our Climate Echo HVAC range. So, starting with a split unit gateway app, what is behind? And again, you find always now on the right side a step-by-step explanation with some arrows here to explain where to go, first of all, helping you to do it also later. So, our split unit gateway, you know, it's an component to connect to different split units via infrared. And the market for split units is very huge, different manufacturers, different remote controls. And our challenge is here to connect the different IR codes from the different manufacturers to our split unit gateway. And this is done via this app. So there is in principle a database behind this app of different manufacturers with their codes and their remote controls. And this is necessary to download the right code into your project, and to download then the right code into the product finally. If you've selected the right component, you make the normal parameterization in the ETS, adding group addresses, and you download via the ETS. So it's a principal product-related app, but you have to take it via the KNX store. It costs nothing, and also this licensing is required. So how to proceed practically? If you have your project, you add your split unit gateway as a normal KNX device into your project. Then where do you find all these apps in your ETS? On top you have here a menu apps, if your app is installed, you find directly this app here. You can select, in our case, a split unit gateway app, a configuration app. So then a new window appears. You see it here on the lower side. with the split units behind, which are in your project. Then you select one split unit gateway. And then on the right side, thanks to this app, you find here the option to select a manufacturer and also a remote control, which is in compliance with the product you have in your project. And then you say, okay, I have here a product with this remote control, and then you find also all supported functions visible here, which might be different depending on the component. And then you can parameterize accordingly everything in the ETS parameters, adding group addresses and so on. And finally, of course, you do the download. And then your product is working, your split unit gateway is working together with your split unit in your project. Let's come to the next app, KNX Bus Update. As mentioned, we talk here about firmware update of various ABB KNX devices. So, how does it proceed? You just open again via apps here, this bus update app. A new window appears like this here. And we have here under device type two options to select. One is ECU12G18. And if you select this, all our, let me say, components at the moment, DALI gateways and also Clamor Echo devices are here behind to be updated via firmware. And so this is one path. So if you know I have to update these kind of devices, you click here. If you have other devices like our presence detector, then we have here also a temperature controller, here motion sensor, but it's listed directly here. You select here the right device. And then, of course, the related products here in your project will be shown. And if you're online, it automatically knows which of these products has a right firmware or which not. And you see here we have made an example. So three products here in this project. One is in compliance with the actual firmware version. The next one is in the project, but not in your project visible because it's not connected here at the moment. So there is no physical connection to your device. And the other one, there is a mismatch between the existing firmware version and the new one. And of course, then there is an update available. Yeah, and how to start this update? I show it to you in the next slide. It's very simple. You click only here on the component you would like to update and click here on update firmware. Yeah. So this app is, let me say, the last version of updating firmware, and target is to integrate in future, in principle, all new devices to be updated here in this app. So not iBus tool anymore, but this update app here. So you see, I click here on the device which can be updated, click on update firmware here, and then the update process also visualized here with a slider will be carried out. Yeah. So as there are a lot of traffic behind, if you update a KNX device via firmware, it's not recommended to do it via a line coupler, so via a line, let me say, separation. Connect your interface directly in the line where the product is installed. That guarantees, let me say, a safe communication to have a correct download. Also here, ABB app, no price, no costs, but also licensing is required here. And for example, here for our DALI gateway, DGS, we have also on our homepage, when you go to the homepage, to the product, a technical information, what is behind this, let me say, firmware update. And yeah, so you can get also here some information. So, and finally, also necessary here to make an application download after you have done your firmware update. This is also required, and finally here. Good, so firmware update, first step we have seen already. Further apps I would like to explain, and one I mentioned already is a very comprehensive one, so-called update copy convert. So it provides numerous useful functions I would like to explain right now. So in principle, five functions are behind. Update changes the application program to a later, earlier version while retaining current configuration. So we have an update for the application in your already existing project with all group addresses and all parameters set already by you, you can update to the actual application but you don't have to create the programming again in the ETS. Yeah. This is quite nice. If necessary, also to a former version, so downgrading in principle possible. Converts, what does it mean? Transfers a configuration from an identical or compatible device to another device. So you have a source device, and you would like to transfer your configuration to another device. I show you an example how it works. And then within a device it's possible to copy channels. So if you have a multi-channel device, copying a channel to others. And if you have necessary to change channels in a component without changing the wiring, the connections, you can do it also with this tool. And last but not least, a special option, it's feasible to import, or first of all, export your device configuration into an XML file. And you can, whatever, maybe in special cases necessary, you can adapt this, because you can import this also into a component again, into other components. Yeah, that might be necessary for some additional softwares where you need this configuration export. Also here, no costs, but licensing required. And for those who are a bit familiar with also older plugins, let's say, we had in the past a so-called plugin copy and convert exchange. And these two functions, copying, exchanging channels, is in principle here in this new app, which we had in the past. But these plugins are an old solution within the ETS, not allowed anymore. So then, of course, we created an app, which isn't a standard now within the ETS, added some functions and created this as a new app. So let's have a look to these different functions. I start with update, change the application program to a later or earlier version while retaining current configuration. So it's possible to keep the parameterization and all link group addresses. Nothing is lost. You only update the application. So let's have a new example. We have here an example with DALI gateways. So in your project is a DALI gateway with an application version 1.0. So it's the older one. You would like to update to the new 1.1 version. So what do? You import, of course, the current version into your database. That's necessary. Then you insert a new DALI gateway in the application on your project as a new component. And and then if you have many of these old, in brackets, DALI gateways, all these old DALI gateways will be detected and can be updated in this way. Yeah. Then you start this app. As always, you could click here on the menu apps, activate this app, and then you select maybe one or maybe more gateways with an older application, and this will be then shown here. Okay, this one, DGS 26411, physical address 211, with the old application version shall be updated. Yeah. So, and then you can choose here, you can do it for all devices, so you don't have to select all your old devices, you can do it here directly, update all devices, you start update, and then the component will be updated with a new application. Good. Also here it's recommended to do it not via line coupler, because again a lot of traffic is here necessary, and that's a process here we can do. It takes time, yes, but if you have already, let me say, an interface like the IP interface here, which supports so-called long frame data transfer, which is in principle a faster communication, so bigger portions will be transferred in one step, then you can also increase the speed here of this process. Okay, so updating the application is a topic. Then we can convert. What does it mean? Transferring the parameterization and link group addresses from a source device to an identical or compatible destination device. Identical device is clear, the same. But what is a compatible device? We have here an example. If you would like to convert your programming from a 4-fold switch actuator to an 8-fold switch actuator, which is not identical but a compatible device. Of course, I can transfer only the 4 channels I have used here to other 4 channels of this 8-fold, but in principle, this is possible. So, how to do? You have to add and then select the destination device in the project, in our case the 8-volt switch actuator. You start the app again, yeah, and click on convert here. So this is here, always on top you see here the different functions we have inside this app, convert. Again, you can say, please show me all compatible devices. So maybe you have a lot of switch actuators in your project. You can then see all of them. Yeah, in this case, we have here some more. Yeah, two-fold, two different components, and the four-fold. Yeah. Then you select the source device you would like to convert to the new one. Set the behavior of your group address copying, and also you can delete the source device if you want directly here. And then, if you'd say, click here on channel assignment, of course you have to say in such a case, okay, I have four channels in the source device, but more channels in the destination device. Okay, what does it mean? One-to-one assignment is possible. Output A in the source belongs to output A in the destination, or you can change it here. You can say, no, no, I need output A for output F in my destination. You select this here, assign this, and then you start here this process of conversion. So parameterization and also link group addresses will be then transferred from the source device to the destination device. Yeah. And then you have to download only the converted application to the destination device again, of course, because this was not yet done here. So what else in this powerful app? Copying channels is possible. So within one device, so no, we do not talk about many devices, but only one device. We would like to let me say, adapt to our requirements. So copying channel parameterization, but also link group addresses from one source channel in the device to one or more destination channels in the same device. So very interesting for multi-channel components. So we create one, let me say, standard parameterization for one channel, and then you copy it only with this app to many other channels in the same device. Can save a lot of time and makes life easier, of course. So how to do? Example here, switch actuator SAS, copy channel A to channel C, D, E, F, so four channels. So you configure channel A as a template, select the device in the project, click on copy channels here in the app, after you have opened the app, of course. Yeah. And then you get again a window here, a pop-up window where you can assign the channel. So the source channel here is output A, and then in our case four destination channels you can select. Then again it's possible to adapt here what to do with the group addresses, retain the group address, copy them, or delete. And then you click here on copy channels. Yeah. So the configuration, parameterization, and group addresses are transferred from the source channel then to the destination channel. The best thing, of course, you do it once by yourself, but hopefully this pictures here helps you later to do this. So what else? Exchanging of channels within this app or within one product is possible. So similar situation, we have chosen here a binary input, and due to wrong wiring in the distribution board, we don't want to rewire this, but we will change easily in the application only the channels. Means in our case we would like to change channel C with channel H. So of course you have configured everything inside the product, select the device, and then you have here another button, exchange channels. Yeah, again this window appears here where you say, okay, channel C with channel F, again the options regarding group addresses, and you started with pressing this button here. Very simple, but can be also quite useful in some cases where you maybe it's not easy to assess the components anymore, so the wiring cannot be changed, yeah, and then you do it via software only. So this was a app update copy convert. Some more apps we have, but not so comprehensive. Export for IP project. So here we are talking again about one product in principle only, our comfort panel, our Big Touch panel, where we have this additional software IP project necessary to program to parameterize a device. But of course, finally we have group addresses to be assigned to this component, and the app is nothing else but making the group address out of the ETS available in this IP project software. Yeah, so you can export from the ETS and import this in the IPP software and also in the other direction. Yeah. So in both directions possible. Yeah. So and then you have only here more or less an import button available. It's hard to see here. Import is on the lower upper left side here to import this or to export this. Okay, it's again a free of charge app available via the KNX App Store and has to be licensed as well. So, and then before we come to the device configuration apps, one other app we have here, also a bit specific, called Move and Group app by our colleagues in France, AB France from Neuron, and a very interesting app, but not for every project, not for everybody. So what is the functionality behind? It's a graphical, let me say, additional environment for very, very fast and user-friendly, let me say, creation of a complete solution, of assigning products, creation of or assignment of group addresses and so on. So it's really on top of software with some special functions. And it's made for bigger projects where you have a lot of things to do and you would like to simplify it. Because in some areas it repeats, for example, an office building where you have the same floors, maybe with the same kind of rooms. We would like to simplify this here. So what do you do? You can create so-called templates, device templates, not only for ABB products, but also for products from other manufacturers. So it might be some pre-work to do before you can start with this, to create these templates for different devices. But finally, in a huge project, it can help you to save time and finally also money. So without going into details here, so there is a collection of objects behind for the different, let me say, hardware, LEMs, switches, and so on, and you connect graphically here, you see it here on the right side a bit, these different objects with each other. You have so-called zones here, which represents, in this case, a functional, let me say, part, can be a room, for example. And automatically, if you connect this, the connection via group addresses will be created, and the functions will be created. And finally, such a object can be reused also in another project, so it's a kind of library you might have then in the future. So the app is not free of charge, depending on the number of data points. You have an in-app purchase necessary. So just to say, to finalize or to summarize, it's a special app for rather bigger projects. But it can help a lot. So I had a contact to a customer who used this in a big project, and he finally said, okay, a bit work to do at the beginning. No, it was work, but then finally it was a real good, efficient solution for me in this project. Good. So these are the more or less standard apps from ABB we have at the moment. And now I come finally to the device configuration apps. DCA is the abbreviation, and it's relatively new. But I think easy to understand, and as we have already two products, it's of course worth to show what's behind. So what does it mean? A DCA device configuration app adds functionality to a KNX product in the ETS. So it's in principle an additional software part where you do normally most of the parameterization, not always, it depends really on the product. So we have still our parameter button, this is not lost here. And if you look here, this is a screenshot here in the ETS, with already open DCA, and you find in addition group objects, in addition to group objects, channels and parameter, a block here DCA. And by clicking on this, the device configuration app for this product will be opened. In my case here, it's from the application controller. So different from the other apps I have explained already, these apps can be always downloaded from our ABB homepage, where you have information about the product. So if you go to the product, you find, of course, all these files and software and documentation, but also these DCA if necessary. It needs no license, so it's no license process necessary. Yeah. And as already mentioned, it works only with the ETS5, because only the ETS5 supports this DCA concept. It's nothing for ETS4 anymore. Yeah. You get this app also on your account in the KNX shop, but I think it's easier to go here to our homepage to download this. So what is at the moment available? Ah, before we come to this, why this DCA concept? I think it's also interesting to understand. It's not an invention by ABB, it's a KNX, topic, so from the KNX organization. And it's just made to implement software options for different devices in the ETS if necessary. Yeah? So practically it replaces the former plugins we had in the KNX world for different components available. Yeah, there were different kinds of plugins, can be only user interface plugin, data handling plugin as well, or only download plugin was existing. So these more or less old plugins are replaced now by this DCA. And so for us as a manufacturer, it's not allowed to use plugin anymore. We have to go, if necessary, to this DCA concept, yeah? Which has also real advantages, because it guarantees a better maintenance in case of any ETS updates, which happens, of course, yeah, or even if you have a Windows operating system update. And sometimes plugins, the former plugins, did not work correctly anymore. The manufacturer has to update this as well. So here is everything integrated in the ETS. So it's much easier to handle, finally, both for you as a user, but also for us as a manufacturer who has to maintain eventually such a tool. So DCA, Device Configuration App, is not a must, it's not mandatory. For us as a manufacturer, it's only an option. If we need more functionality, we cannot cover with a normal parameterization dialog, which is still part of each ETS, KNX product. Though if you have DCA, it can happen that you do not have so many parameters anymore, because everything is inside the DCA, the Device Configuration App. So focus still in products, if possible, on a native ETS parameter dialog, which is known and also still okay, absolutely. So, small look to these two apps we have at the moment. I mentioned already this application controller app, ACS configuration. It's just to configure the application controller, which is a big part of our new HVAC solution, Climate Echo. For numerous functions, this component creation of automation-specific, application-specific automation modules, so some modules for different components like boiler-chiller interface. You can program freely any logic inside. You have a BACnet interface to be configured here, as well as a web user interface. So all these things you are doing here in a graphical environment inside the DCA, because it's not possible to do it directly in a parameter dialog, which is only text-oriented. Yeah? Assignment of group addresses and also download, of course, is done in the main part of the ETS. This is not here inside the device configuration app. So, possible, of course, to take also from our homepage, because it's device-oriented app, no license required, and of course free of charge. And you'll find it at the application controller. And the second device, also topic HVAC from our Climate Echo range, the building automation controller, which is a powerful component based on our ABB's PLC, AC500. And this PLC will be programmed, first of all, the logic inside via the so-called automation builder. So it's an additional external software, first of all, we use here as well. You need a connection finally to the ETS. And your, let me say, assignment of KNX data points within this project you have done in the automation builder to the ETS will be exported from the automation builder and imported here in the ETS via this DCA, this device configuration app. Yeah. So finally, you export from the automation builder an XML file with your KNX data points, import it here, and the DCA, you see it here, is nothing else but loading this configuration, this XML file from the automation builder software. And then you have your required ETS data points, group objects available where you assign group addresses and download, and then it's connected to your logic, your intelligence inside the building automation controller. So it's a very simple process here with the DCA. You have here neither many parameters, but still a parameter part here, and this simple device configuration app. So you see it can be totally different what a DCA is used for in a product. But if you're interested in more details, we have done also webinars for both the application controller, also building automation controller last year, where we have shown, explained this DCAs in principle a bit more detailed. Good, so I stop here. I hand over now to Jürgen. Jürgen will continue a bit with the IBAS tool, but a bit more as well. Interesting further aspects around our tools in ETS or in KNX. Just a moment, please.
Hello and welcome. Jürgen Schilder is speaking. Today I'm going to talk about two main topics. The first is about the firmware update we can do via the IBAS tool, for example the IP router, IP interface, or via a web user interface. We can do an update in the security panel and in our Ecumatic Energy Analyzer. The other main topic will be how we can do analyzing or recording KNX Net IP telegrams on the IP level. You know, in our KNX twisted pair level, we have our ETS group bus monitor, but how we can see and do analyzing of KNX Net IP telegrams. So just a second. Okay, so now let me start with the first topic about the KNX or ABB IBAS tool. The IBAS tool is a free of charge software which can be used, for example, for diagnostic or for commissioning and other tools. It is not new. We have done also some webinars. You can download this IBAS tool for free of charge from our website abb.com/knx. Go to the submenu Services and Tools, Engineering Tools, and then you will guide it to our landing page here of the ABB IBAS tool. You get some more information about the latest plugins, for example, what you can do, all supported devices. And you here with the on the lower left hand side, you can download the latest version of this IBAS tool. Yesterday we launched a new version, so go online and update here our IBAS tool. Here you can see our given webinars. One was in March 2014, the other in March 2017. We talked really in details about the IBAS tool, what you can do, how to configure, for example, the ETS connections about IP or USB and so on. So now when you go to our training database, you can go here to our selector and select, for example, the webinars, slides or recordings, and then you will be forwarded to the PDF file or to YouTube, and you can watch the videos about this IBAS tool. Now I will give only some short introduction. What is the IBAS tool? It helps, for example, the installer and the system integrator for commissioning and service. It is installed on in the same PC like the ETS, but it can be also installed independent the ETS. Via the ETS we do the complete parameterization, the download, the linking the group address and everything. Via the IBAS tool we can have also connection via IP or via twisted pair to a device and read out, for example, the configuration to check all the parameters. Like in a shutter actuator, we have so many parameters about priority, if it's rain, wind or forced operation. And so via the IBAS tool, we can simulate a lot of things and read out our parameterization. Via the IBAS tool, we cannot change a parameter or we cannot make a download or we cannot, for example, link a group address. So this is absolutely independent, the ETS. And now with the IBAS tool, we can do also the updates. This is now our main topic of some ABB KNX devices. So the IBAS tool supports a wide range of KNX devices, started here from analog actuators, of course the DALI gateways, the N-Ocean gateways, all our Klima Echo devices, the line coupler for example, up to the weather station or the power supplies. And all new devices are added continuously to the IBAS tool, like for example the new Universal DIMM Actuator UDS is also supported via the IBAS tool. So what is also inside is our DALI tool software. So via the DALI tool software, we can address our DALI devices and we can assign our DALI devices to the DALI groups. Or we can do, for example, some diagnostics or also about the test of the emergency converter, or we can use it for commissioning of the constant light control. Now, what is also inside the IBAS tool is the discovery tool. The discovery tool scans the IP network and shows you all KNX IP devices, like for example the IP routers, application controllers, the former telephone gateway, yeah, and all these devices will be shown here in the list. You can see also the IP address, yeah, you can see the MAC address of the devices, you can see the status of KNX, twist the pair if it's okay. Yeah, you can tick here one device, Brock LED, and so you can start flashing the LED of the device. You can identify it maybe in your distribution board. Additionally, on the last column, you can see the firmware version, if it's necessary to make a firmware update of the device. And now when you go lower, there's also a checkbox, which shows you more detailed data. So when you tick it, then I get you more information about this device. So for example, also the firmware and some more information. So what is also inside is our firmware update tool. So before we start with the firmware update, go to the update menu and check if a new update for a device is available. At the moment, you can make a firmware update via the IP router, IP interface, or the logic controller. So now when you are online, the IBAS tool makes a connection or connects our update server, and then you get the information, oh, there is a new update available, like for example, here our IP interface. Then you get here orange explanation mark. You can check here the download box and click here on the button download. And then the IBAS tool downloads the firmware version, like for example, now the version 10494 for the IP interface, and store it here in our standard IBAS tool folder, binaries firmware. So in this folder you can find all update files for these devices. So this is the first step you have to do. So and then we go here to the IP devices, click here on the main menu on the update button, and then we can see all devices which can be updated via the IBAS tool. This is the IP interface, IP router, and our application controller. So in the right column you see a lot of arrows, which means the firmware is up to date. But here, for example, in my IP interface, you can see the explanation mark, and then it's necessary to update this device. So how to do it? So you mark it, or you tick here the checkbox. You click on the button, start update. This is here the green one. And then a new window pops up, shows you again the information. This is my IP interface with this IP address. You see here now the firmware version, which is inside the device. And then maybe here on top, you select the latest firmware version, and then click on the button Start, and the update process now starts. You can do an update parallel. So this IBAS tool does a firmware update not via twisted pair. It will do it via the IP network. And so you can make an update of several IP devices at the same time, yeah, to save also time. Don't do it step by step. Select all devices which must be updated and press here the Start button, and the update will be done simultaneously at more devices. Sometimes it can happen that you get a failure message, update not possible, missing admin rights. This maybe depends on the admin rights of your laptop, like special situation we have here at ABB. In this case, close the IBAS tool, go here on your desktop, click on the IBAS tool icon, right mouse click, and then run this program as an administrator. And then you have temporary administration rights, and then you can make here this update. Good, some words about the security panel, GMA 8.1. We have also to update the firmware of the security panel. It's mandatory. So, but here with the security panel, we have two updates to do. One is the update of the firmware of the security panel itself, and additionally of the update of the KNX bus coupled unit. So we need two updates files. So please go on the website abb.com/knx, go to the security panel and download the firmware file the firmware file for the panel GMA 8.1, and additionally an update file for the KNX bus coupled unit. So additionally, there is firmware information available, kind of guidance how to do it. So also as a PDF, so please download here this file. So and then we start with the update. This is the status of today, of February. We need here the application version 7.5.8. Here on the right side, you can see the screenshot of the security panel. And here we have a former version 7.4.4. It means we have to make a firmware update followed by the update of the KNX BusCup unit. So to do an update, you need the admin rights, so-called programming rights. The first step is to log in as a user, followed by the administrator or user with the programming rights. Go to the menu Main Menu and then System General. So here you can see again the version, like here we have 7.4.4. So what we have to do at the first step is to read again here the manual, how to do it. I showed you now step by step, and do an export of the existing configuration. After the download, the programming and everything else is still retained. But to be sure that there now is nothing happens or failure during the update, it's highly recommended before we start the update procedure to export the complete configuration, like for example here in the file, which is the name of the system, and .back, and save it maybe on your hard disk. And then we start the process. We go again here to our manual generally, press on the button firmware update, then a new window pops up, and now we need the so-called manufacturer password. According to the worldwide IEC standard, when we make an update, we need in the security system, we need a manufacturer code. And you can find this manufacturer password in the firmware information file, which is also available on our website. So enter here the manufacturer password, click on the button OK, a new window pops up, you click here on the button import, and then you see your hard disk, select the update file, press OK, and then the update procedure will start, maximum about 20 minutes. And during this time, do not switch off the system. It works. It needs really sometimes really 20 minutes. It depends on the size of your intrusion alarm system with all the bus modules and motion detectors and so on. So after the firmware update was successfully, you can see here the latest version, like here, version of the application 7.5.8. The next step is we have to do the update of the KNX BusCup unit. Similar procedure, but now we have to click here on the button KNX firmware update in our main menu programming. Again, we have to enter the same manufacturer password and load the file, click on the button OK, but this update will last between 1 or 2 minutes. And afterwards, we have updated also the KNX BusCup unit. And remember, the complete parameterization, also our link group addresses, everything is still retained. Good, so far, how we make an update in the KNX security panel. The next one is how we can make an update in our Acumatic Energy Analyzer, QoS. So we, at the moment, we have two devices. One is to connect MBUS or Modbus meters. This year we launched the energy analyzer for Modbus. At the same time, we launched a new update for the MBUS. The MBUS we have launched last year, but we added more software features. So it's also recommended to update here our MBUS energy analyzer to have more features. For example, to send reports per email or send it maybe to a FTP server and so on. So in the end, this update is also done via the web user interface. But here again, you need the admin rights. So you must have this role to do this update. An end user with no admin rights cannot do it. To see the version of this energy analyzer, we go here in our main menu on top. We click on the information button and then we get the information of this energy analyzer, the type, like here QoS 3.16.1. We get the order code and you can see here the version, which is for example the version 1.5.1. To make an update, go to the product page of the device, to the energy analyzer and download the firmware file for the Modbus or for the MBUS energy analyzer. And again, we have a software information which describes how to do it step by step. This is for the manual update and we can do also automatic update can be activated. I'll show you in the next slides. But at first, the so-called manual update. So now when you are logged in and you have the admin role, then you have here the menu, main menu system. You go to the submenu update and then you have here the manual update button. Manual update button means you click on the button, select update, then the window pops up and you have to select here the file, the update file, which is on your hard disk. Click on the button OK and then this update now will start and will last some minutes. And after some minutes, everything is still retained, your complete configuration. You can check again if it was successful when you go here on the information button. And please check also your complete dashboard if everything is okay. Another possibility is to do the automatic or to enable the automatic update. Automatic means You need also here the URL to an update server. On this update server, there we provide all our new updates. So you can keep it like it is. It's the default settings. And then the device every time asks here our update server, new update available. If yes, and then in the main menu here, you see here a yellow number. It means you have one information. And then when you click on this yellow one, and then another window pops up and informs you or notify you that the update is available, and then you can trigger this update manual. So the update is not installed automatically. Really, you get only the information that it's available, and then you can start it. Good, so far the update via the web user interface of the energy analyzer. Let's come to a very interesting topic is to about analyzing of KNX NetIP telegrams on the IP level. Like here we have a typical situation. We have a building with more areas, more lines, and we link our different lines and areas via the IP router. Thanks to this IP router, we can use here the existing or separate IP network to link here our area and lines. In this line, line number 1, 2, we have some devices like here our weather unit and weather sensor. This weather unit sends cyclically every minute this telegram 141 with the value 0, no wind alarm, into our KNX twisted pair line, maybe to other devices. And in our other line, the line 38, which is maybe another building part on the same, maybe on the same place, we have our shutter actuator and we have our motors. So, and this shutter actuator is listening cyclically to our weather unit and weather sensor. Like every minute, the weather unit sends a telegram via the IP network to other IP routers, into this line, and the shutter actuator receives it cyclically and knows the communication from the shutter actuator to the weather unit is okay. And if it does not receive this information cyclically, then he drives into the safety position. And maybe if this one is happen, then maybe there's some problems with the communication from this weather unit or via IP to this shutter actuator. But how we can test it, how we can find where is the problem? Is it maybe here in the line? Is it this IP router? Is it here on our IP network? Or is it this IP router? There are different possibilities how to check it. At first, start here in the line of the weather unit and weather sensor. So with our standard ETS tools like the group monitor or the bus monitor, we can check if the weather unit sends cyclically every minute this signal 141 with the value 0, no wind alarm, or not. Or maybe we have here done make wrong settings, like for example every 5 minutes, or link the wrong group address or something. That's what we can do with our standard ETS. Additionally, with the iBus tool, we can simulate here a wind alarm. So the weather unit will send here the wind alarm telegrams, which we can record or see on the bus, and we can read out also the settings via the iBus tool of our weather unit. So we can check if here the weather unit and the weather sensor is okay here in our line. This is not new, this is standard ETS. So, but now, what about our IP router? So this IP router, he receives also the telegram 141, no wind alarm, and he has to forward it into the IP network. So the IP router takes this KNX twisted pair telegram and embedded it into a KNX net IP telegram and send it on the IP network. So what we can do, we take here our laptop, we use IP monitor tool. There are different on the market available. Later I show you one. And we listen here on the IP network telegrams. And then via a special tool, we can see here our KNX telegram, which is embedded in an IP telegram. So we start here our IP monitor tool. We simulate here wind alarm, or wait 1 minute to see if the IP router takes this KNX twisted pair telegram and embedded it into an IP telegram. In the KNX world, we use our standard KNX multicast address, for example, 224.0.23.12, including here our information of group address and the value. And if the telegram is not available here, or with another group address, or with another multicast address, then we know maybe there's something wrong here with our IP router. And the tool, for example, to see these telegrams on the IP network is the so-called Wireshark. It's a very popular one software. Later, I go give you some more information about the software. But this works similar to our ETS bus or group monitor. We can see here all all IP telegrams, maybe from your network attached storage or from your printer or what else. And here my telegram 97, when I selected it, I get here more details about this telegram, and thanks to the Wireshark, we see here in clear messages our telegrams. You see here the source address. Source address means this is the IP address of our IP router, which sent this IP telegram into the IP world. Like for example, 192.168.0.109. So the destination address of this telegram is our KNX multicast address, which should be used. And exactly this multicast address is used for communication between all KNX IP routers, independent of the manufacturer. So this is default, and you see it is correct. So he sent it into the IP world. In our so-called useful data, we see our complete embedded twisted pair telegram. You see here 126. This is the individual address of my weather unit in my line. You see here again, you see here also our KNX group address, the 141. We see the command group value write, and we see here our value 0. In this information, we know that the IP router is okay. The IP router has embedded our KNX telegram 141 with the value 0 and the command value write into a KNX net IP telegram with the correct destination address of our KNX net IP telegram. So we know on this point that the IP router is okay. He forwarded the telegrams into the IP network. The next step is we go nearby here, the IP router in our area 8, line number 8, for example. We do the same. We connect our laptop with the monitor tool nearby the IP router to see if the telegram is forwarded via all the hubs, routers and switches, for example, here to this IP router. Yeah, we're using here the so-called multicast telegrams, and some routers or switches or hubs, they blocks multicast telegrams because system administrator, they don't like multicast telegrams. So now when you start again here the IP monitor tool and everything is okay, then you will see that this twisted pair telegram is embedded into IP telegram and forwarded to this IP switch here to the IP router. So next step, we go into the line of our shutter actuator, and via our standard ETS tools like the group monitor, bus monitor, or IBUS tool, we can check here the settings, we can read out the configuration, for example, of the shutter actuator, we can record here our telegram, and so on. So with this additional tool for scanning here our IP network and do analyzing, we can check the telegram with standard ETS software here, IP, and here. So we can do a complete diagnostic. Some words about this special software like IP monitor tool. I recommend, it's also was because it's quite popular, to use the Wireshark software. Of course, there are other software like Wireshark available on the market, but Wireshark is popular because a lot of organization or user groups, for example, they will use it, they will support, they write here, for example, some plugins, and it is free of charge. Before you install the Wireshark, please contact your local network administrator because he must allow to install this Wireshark. With Wireshark, you can see all telegrams on the IP network, not only KNX, also, for example, passwords from email accounts and so other things. So you can download this Wireshark. Oh, sorry, one step back. To see this KNX net IP telegrams in the Wireshark, we need a kind of special file. So, and this is so-called DIS-Sektor. This is a name created by the KNX Association. So the KNX Association has created such a DIS-Sektor file for Wireshark. And via this file, you can see here maybe in plain text our KNX twisted pair telegram about here our useful data, the group address, and so on. So that's why we need two things. One is, at first, download the Wireshark from wireshark.org. It is free of charge for Windows 32, 64, also for Mac operating system. You can download it free of charge, follow the standard installation, and then it's installed. To see, for example, our KNX telegrams in plain text, we need this so-called DIS-Sektor. You can download DIS-Sektor on the website of the KNX installation. Go to support.knx.org. Here is, for example, a search field. Enter here Wireshark. And you get also here a short quick guidance how to install this DIS-Sektor in the Wireshark program. And here's a download of this DIS-Sektor. So when you start a download, it's a zipped file called KNX IP Wireshark DIS-Sektor plugin zip. Unzip this file, and in this unzipped folder, you will find one single file which is called KNX LP or IP, sorry, IP DLL. So you have to copy this file into the standard folder of your Wireshark, which is default program files, Wireshark plugins 2.6 EPUN, exactly in this folder. And then you can run the Wireshark and you see here in clear text your KNX Telegram. So these are the two steps you have to do. Download the Wireshark, install it, and download this KNX IP DLL, so-called dissector software. Good, but what about KNX IP Secure? Remember, it is still possible to have here a secure communication on the IP network between the IP routers. All KNX telegrams are now encrypted. Then you see nothing because it's encrypted, it's KNX IP Secure. But if you want to see also the communication, you have to go to the ETS where you have all your KNX IP router secure. And then we have here the possibility to export all these decryption keys for the communication between the IP routers in a single file, a so-called keyring file. And in the Wireshark, we can import this keyring file and then we can encrypt, or the Wireshark encrypts all the telegram in this field also, and you can see it as a plain text. More about KNX IP Secure, we will introduce you in 4 weeks in our next webinar. What is KNX IP Secure? And we introduce you the KNX Secure IP Router. So, here again the overview for diagnostic. When we use here in our Twisted Pairlines our KNX standard tools like Boost Monitor, Group Monitor, IBUS tool, together here with Wireshark on IP, we can do maybe for complete analysis in our complete installation, Twisted Pair and also IP. Good, so far this was one of my topic about the firmware update. We had the IBUS tool, web user interface, and how we can use the Wireshark software. Thank you for listening and goodbye. I hand over now to Thorsten.
Yeah, thank you, Jürgen. You got a lot of information today from our side. So see our webinar today also as a kind of tutorial for you later or for your customers to know later how to handle all these topics like firmware update and the different apps. So together with our feedback email where you get all these this is the presentation and also the video, it should be possible. And as you know, we store also these files then in our training database. So it's all available later. And I think it's quite useful also for others in the future to look inside and to check how it works. So we got a lot of questions in this regard during our trainings. And we decided to have such a kind of webinar to inform you a bit more detailed. And other small information, Jürgen has shown the IBUS tool, version 35 was shown there. Now we have already 36. So just yesterday there came an update for this ABB IBUS tool, which takes place continuously. And what I remember, the boiler chiller interface IBUS tool part is now also integrated. One topic behind this one. Okay, good. Yeah, a bit later than 1 hour, but only very few slides left just to give you the information. For your information, it's also on the KNX homepage. There are also webinars available that you can join, but also you can have access later to the recording of this webinar. There are also some interesting webinars, sometimes also done together with companies. Jürgen did recently a common webinar together with the KNX organization, so you find here on the homepage everything and of the KNX organization, including the record webinars. They have also an own YouTube channel here available. Then of course, as always, our training database where we store everything. So also our webinar from today will come very soon there. But you, of course, you get also this feedback email with a direct link. We have also a calendar of all our trainings. So we have done a lot of trainings. I will do a lot of trainings this year as well. So also classroom trainings here in Heidelberg or in Lüdenscheid. As always, we have certified trainings over the year. And Jürgen is doing next week already the first basic course, 5 days course. But further certified courses will follow. In July, the advanced, the tutor course in September, and a further basic course in October. Everything you find in our training calendar. Yeah, and as already mentioned by Jürgen, our next webinar on the 20th of March will deal with this topic, secured communication on IP together with KNX. There is a new component also behind IP router secure. So this topic is coming up now also with real products very soon then available, so you get the invitation of course, and as always two webinars in the morning and the afternoon. Then I say thank you for your participation, for your patience today, a bit longer than 1 hour. Thank you, see you next time, bye bye, ciao.